Hi, it's Susanna Betroy, and my Bloomberg is getting a little closer to being in big trouble. I don't know how they can say he is in no way responsible, but right now, one guy and one guy only is supposedly solely to blame for $750,000 that Mike Bloomberg can't explain where that money went the day before the election. It's more complicated than that, but to put in the simplest form, this man is taking all the blame, and his response is this: if I'm the fall guy, if I'm going to be scapegoated, then I'm going to sing. I'm going to tell everything I know about the inner workings of the Bloomberg campaign, which I think is fantastic. I can't wait to hear that. I hope he just sings and tells us everything. I'm hoping for jail time here, as well as, you know, with certain city council members and their staff members. It's just, there's too much corruption. David Sifman gets an A+ and gold stars because he's been reporting on this all along. This brings me to Stieg Larsson, the author of The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. The real title is The Men Who Hate Women. New York Times, there's a review of the third book. They don't mention there is a fourth book. So if you want to read the review, it's a pretty good review of the third book. What happened was he wrote three books. They're a trilogy. And he died of a heart attack. But if you go to his website, you find out there's a fourth book. He didn't have a will, so his partner in life is not official, but his wife, and they never made it official, and he didn't make a will. She has the fourth book on her computer, and she said she worked with him and the father and brother who inherited his estate. She said weren't involved in his life, and until she gets what's rightfully hers, she's not sharing the fourth book. All three books have been made into movies in Sweden, and they're going to be made into probably American films. One is already in the works. And it's amazing because this woman is like the female Johnny Depp, the actress, and this female character is amazing. But most of all, it's about misogyny, how hatefully women are treated. And there's very specific ways powerful women are treated that's just disgusting. But he covers it all. Because he obviously supported women and our rights and appreciated intelligent women. So his books are amazing. He's about democracy. He valued democracy above all. And also he really was against corruption. I think about corruption here in the city level, which is just shocking, down to the community boards, major conflicts of interest. You know, with bars, you'll have bar owners and their family members on community boards when bars and nightlife are the number one complaint. There's so much corruption with community boards all the way up to City Hall and conflicts of interest. It's like an orgy of admiration. So he gets into all kinds of corruption. His books are taking place in Sweden. But the reason it's a bestseller and just so successful in America is because people are sick of corruption, whether it's government or corporate. He gets into the financial, you know, Wall Street corruption. So that's why this book is so timely. That's why I talk about Bloomberg and I'm talking about this book. So you can see the movie. It's out in the theaters. It's very violent. The book is fascinating. So check out his books.